You, as a beginner in shoemaking, don't need to have all the tools and materials that exist in shoemaking. You can start learning and making your shoes with minimum basic set of tools and materials. So today I want to show you the tools and materials that I have in my kit. So let's start from the materials you have in this kit. These two cardboards, Texan cardboard and shank board, you need to create insoles plus steel shanks that you will place between these two layers of the cardboard. Why we need insoles? Without insoles, we can't last our shoes. We will attach the edge of the upper on this side of the insole. The problem is that factory-made insoles like this one will not suit any shoe last, the shoe last that you work with. It's used only for the last for which these insoles were made. For example, I work with this shoe last and I have this factory-made insole. So you see, I can't place this insole to this shoe last. And this is the problem that you have with ready-made insoles. That's why in my courses I teach how to make insoles like factory-made, but for any shoe last, for the shoe last that you work with. Next material is this chemical non-woven fabric. We need to work with to create stiffeners that will place between upper and lining, and these stiffeners will keep the shape of our footwear. And it's very easy to work with. You need to work with some solvent to activate this fabric. In the toolkit included materials that will be enough approximately for 4 pairs of shoes. Next is the shoe last. Without shoe last, you can't make your shoes. And I have 2 types of the shoe last. Good for any type of the court shoes, like flat ballet shoes, Oxford shoes, derby shoes, and so on. So you have to choose between these 2 types of the shoe last. Pointed toe shoe last and rounded toe shoe last. This one has heel height of 2 centimeters, and the rounded toe shoe last 1.5 centimeters. Pincers. You need to work with these 2 during lasting. You will grab edges of the upper and lining with this jaw and will attach it to the insole, working with this part of the pincers, the hammer. It's an excellent Italian pincers that I use in my work. Shoemaking grasp that we can use in many different steps, like flattening the shoe bottom, sanding heel, sanding insole and sole, so in many steps. It has 4 different sides, 2 sides with curved shape and 2 sides with flat surface. Shoemaker's hammer. We use this hammer a lot in shoemaking in many different steps. It has 2 sides. This one, big one with rounded shape, and the narrow one that we use in heel making, in flattening the stitches, back stitches. This one, instead of special hammer for the folding, we can use this one as well. So it's good for many different steps in shoemaking. Shoemaker's knife. This is excellent Italian shoemaker's knife that I always recommend to all my students to work with. Why? Because it has this curved blade that is very comfortable to work with during skiving. You can manipulate with it and create different angles during skiving, to skive it thinner, to skive it not so thin. And what is important also is that it comes already sharp, okay? So for the first steps of your work, you don't need to sharpen it, because it takes time to learn how to sharpen your knife. And it's easy to maintain it, to sharp it and keep it always sharp. Silver pen that we need to mark all important marks on leather. It's erasable pen, so after you will finish your work, you see how it marks, you can erase it very easy with a piece of rubber. Shoemaker's measurement tape that we need during drawing our shoe designs on the shoe last. Working with this tape, we can easily measure certain distances to find very important lines and points on our shoe last. It's very comfortable to work with, and it has metric points and inches. This is beginner's kit with most valuable and necessary tools and materials that you, as a beginner in shoemaking, need to have to start learning and making your shoes. Thank you for watching.